What is up and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to discuss Ozempic. Is it the ultimate weight loss aid or is it just a fad? Get ready as we dive into the world of Ozempic, the groundbreaking medication that is making waves in the weight loss community. From Hollywood buzz to scientific research, we're exploring the truth behind Ozempic's claim to fame. Is it just another passing trend or is it here to stay? Stay tuned as we're going to discuss the stories behind the Ozempic drug, the side effects, the science behind it, and also the potential that is going to help you in your weight loss journey. So buckle up because we're gonna dive deep into the skinny on Ozempic, and this is not a video you're gonna wanna miss. So if you're ready, let's get started. By the way, if you're new here, my name is Seppi. I'm passionate about health, nutrition, weight loss, and living with ADHD. As someone who has ADHD and has lost over 50 pounds over the past few years, I'm excited to share all of my knowledge and experience with you guys on this channel. My videos are all about providing practical and evidence-based information that you can apply to your life every single day to improve your health, optimize your nutrition, manage your weight loss, and thrive with ADHD. I'm so excited to share all of this with you on my channel, and if you are too, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, click the notification bell so you will never miss a video from me. Let's get started with the rest of the video on Ozempic. If you clicked on this video, you probably already know what Ozempic is. Yes, it does help with weight loss, but it originally was created for people who have type 2 diabetes. It is an injectable and it helps people with type 2 diabetes regulate their blood sugar. Ozempic belongs to a class of drug that is called glucagon-like peptide 1 receptor agonist. Receptor agonist's job is to actually enhance a certain receptor or hormone in our body, enhance their job. And in this case, it enhances the job of insulin for us. Now I'm going to be sharing a little bit of the science in basic words for you guys because I'm really interested always in the science of, you know, things that I talk about. If you're not interested, there are chapters ahead that you can skip through the part that you would like to hear most about. So to give you a picture of how everything works, when you eat food, especially when it has carbohydrates in it, your pancreas is going to release insulin. Insulin's job is to unlock the doors on your cells so glucose or the carbs from your food can actually go into your cells and be used for energy. The extra glucose that is in your body and left and you're not going to use it immediately for energy is going to be actually stored in your liver and your muscles as glycogen. So when you eat a lot of carbohydrates over a long period of time, you're going to have a lot of glucose in your blood because your insulin is going to be spiked regularly. And as time goes by, if you continue this over a long period of time, as this goes by, your body and your cells are going to lose their sensitivity to insulin. So insulin won't be doing its job properly. And as a result, you're going to have a lot of glucose floating around your blood, and that's what we call a high blood sugar. So basically what Ozempic does, it enhances the work of insulin. So insulin can actually work better and regulate the blood sugar a lot better, store less and use a lot more of it for energy. And that's why we recommend taking Ozempic and workout because you're getting a lot of glucose into your cells so you can use it for energy. And it's always good to work out and make sure you use that energy as well. So Ozempic helps us in 5 different ways. We're gonna talk about all of it in this video. The first one we just talked about is regulating blood sugar. The second one is appetite control, and it does it in 2 different ways. Unlike other supplements that are on the market right now, those supplements usually create a gel in your stomachs to help you feel full, but Ozempic does it differently. One way this drug helps with appetite control is that it actually increases the tension in the lower part of your stomach, so it slows down the movement of food from your stomach to your intestines. Another way it helps, it releases more of a peptide called YY or PYY, which is responsible for the speed that your stomach gets rid of the food. The longer the food remains in your stomach, the fuller you will feel, and that's how it helps with appetite control. So for now, just to recap, we talked about Ozempic helping with regulating blood sugar, it helps us with appetite control, and the third way it helps, it actually affects and signals through our gut-brain axis. These neurological pathways, if they're improved by Ozempic, it will help us regulate our appetite, it will better our food intake, and it will help us with more energy metabolism. The fourth way Ozempic is thought to help us is with our lipid profile, which is our HDL, LDL, cholesterol. It also helps with blood pressure as well. So last but not the least, and the fifth way Ozempic is thought to help us is with weight loss, which is the title of this video. We're gonna dive a little deeper into this. We're gonna talk about some of the research that is out there, and we're gonna talk about our decision and our verdict that is this something that we should actually try and take. There are a few clinical trials that we're going to dive deep into in this video that have shown significant weight reduction in people who have diabetes and people who don't. In a double-blind placebo study done in 2021, there were 1,961 adults with a BMI of 30 or greater, so they were basically a little overweight. They received semaglutide, which is another name for Ozempic, or they received a placebo, which is a fake pill, for 68 weeks, which is a long period of time, and that was along with life intervention. So people who participated in this study, they could work out, they could do whatever they wanted. It wasn't a controlled study. They showed significant changes in their body weight circumference, but their body weight significantly dropped to 5%. 20 weeks into the research, in order to make sure the effects were legitimate, they switched some people that were actually taking Ozempic to a placebo pill. So they started giving them fake pills, and they noticed something very interesting. They noticed a mean body weight reduction of 7.9% from week 20 to week 68, compared to an increase of 6.9% in those who switched to placebo. Waist circumference, blood pressure, and physical functioning score, which is a test your physician actually gives you when you go to their office, they make you walk on a treadmill, they measure your heartbeat and things like that, that actually improved. And honestly, as it should, because if your weight is dropping, that automatically will improve as well. So at this point, do you guys have any questions? Does it all make sense? If you do, make sure you leave a comment down below and I will for sure answer in details for you. But one of the questions that you might bring up is that since this research wasn't controlled, for example, and people could do whatever they want, how would that affect the research? If I'm taking the pill, I'm going for this experiment, I'm very motivated to lose weight already, so maybe I'm eating better, maybe I'm exercising more, so would that affect? Yes, it would affect it, but because some people are taking the placebo, they are basically taking into effect that some people are taking the fake pill, and you can see a significant difference in people who were taking the pill and who weren't. Another question that I asked myself while I was doing the research, I saw if there was a conflict of interest, and yes, there was. There's Dr. Rubino and Davis, who were mentioned as the research heads of the program, who are associated with Novo Nordisk, which is a pharmaceutical company that potentially is providing or producing these pills. So therefore, there is a conflict of interest, but the research seems pretty legit, and we've heard about the pill actually working for people who are trying to lose weight, so we know that it works. I found another research called Pioneer One, funded by the same company, Novo Nordisk. I don't know if that's fishy or not. If it is, you guys let me know in the comments. But when I looked at the research, it looked legitimate, and it was a clinical trial. It was randomized and it was a placebo. They shared the information. I'm sure they're being very honest with their data. And we've already heard the stories of Ozempic helping with the weight loss. So we know that it works. So I'm not really suspicious of these researches and how it helps with weight loss. But I wanted to talk about this research because it did compare Ozempic again with a placebo, and they found that it helped people experience weight reductions ranging from 2.9 kilograms to 4.3 kilograms over a 56-week period. So in the clinical trials that I shared with you guys on this video and the ones that I went through myself as I was doing my research, it shows and proves that Ozempic does help with weight reduction in people with or without diabetes. However, Ozempic is an injectable drug, so if you are thinking about taking it, I definitely recommend you talk to a healthcare professional and discuss with them before using this drug. So if you're gonna be taking Ozempic, I want you to know the side effects. If you experience any of it, you know what it is. You can talk to a doctor, you can stop using the drug, and I wanted to educate you on that. There were actually about seven of them, so I wrote them down on my phone, so I'm gonna be reading it to you. The first one was the gastrointestinal problems, which includes nausea, constipation, diarrhea, things like that. A lot of people had to opt out of the clinical trials when they were doing the clinical research because of this main reason. So out of the people who were taking placebo, 15.3% of them experienced gastrointestinal reactions. So meaning that you are taking a fake pill and you are experiencing those reactions. You're reporting that you have some kind of a nausea, diarrhea, you know, constipation. So that kind of shows when you're taking a fake pill, you are looking for anything that's happening within you and you're kind of blaming it on the pill. Whereas it could have just been happening to you even if you were not taking the pill, right? But 32.7% of people who were taking 0.5 milligrams of Ozempic, they reported the same say. And also people who were taking 1 milligram, 36.4% of them reported that they were experiencing gastrointestinal adverse effects. The second thing here is a decreased appetite. While some people would like that, some people may not prefer that. They would like to be eating. They're already having problems with their appetite. So that's also something to look for. The next one is the injection site reaction. Because you're going to be probably injecting every single day or at least 3 times a week, you're going to notice a lot of redness and swelling. It is a sub-Q injection. You're going to see redness, swelling, and maybe sometimes when you over-inject in the same spot, you're going to actually get like some tough skin there and you're not going to like it. So that's something to keep in mind. And the next one is hypoglycemia. It's basically low blood sugar. You know when you feel like you want to faint when you haven't eaten for a while or you just had a really crazy workout? That's what it is. So the next one is pancreatitis, which is rare, but it's very scary to me. As we talked about in the science, Ozempic affects the hormone insulin, and insulin is produced by pancreas, so it affects it and it may cause inflammation in the pancreas. So that's something to keep in mind. The next one is thyroid tumors. There are studies in animals who have shown increased risk of thyroid C-cell tumors with semaglutide, and it's not recommended for individuals with a personal or family history of thyroid. So something I recommend if you're thinking about taking this hormone is to check with your doctor, check your thyroid before doing so. The next one is allergic reactions, which is rare, but they could include rash, itching, swelling of the lips, face, tongue, throat. So this is also a possibility as well. It is important to know not everybody is going to be reacting the same way to a drug. It's impossible to predict how each individual will predict to something like that. So I do advise in general, always talk to your healthcare professional before taking something new, and always be on top of your health and always test as much as you can to make sure that everything's working properly. In this part of the video, we're going to talk about the main concern of people who are thinking of taking Ozempic, which is the Ozempic face. Ozempic face is caused by losing facial fat muscles and skin elasticity, and as a result, you're going to get this droopy face. And of course, not everybody is going to experience the same facial changes. It depends on the age, your diet, your height, your skin, everything that you can think of. So it might not happen to you, but it might happen to the next person. In my opinion, this is not a side effect of Ozempic. It's just a side effect of rapid weight loss. If you are losing a lot of weight rapidly, you're going to be losing a lot of fat around your muscles in your face, and your skin and your muscles will not have enough time to bounce back. So you have to give it more time. If you do get the droopy skin, give it time and exercise your facial muscles and your skin will hopefully bounce back. And that's basically my advice on this section. So in the last part of the video, we're going to talk about if I do recommend this drug or not. Well, obviously, if you guys know me and you know my channel, I'm all about healthy, sustainable weight loss. So losing more than 1 pound a week for me is crazy, because what if we took the drug for 20 weeks to 60 weeks and we lost a little bit of weight? If you don't have the good skills and the good habits to maintain it, it will all come back at some point, correct? So what I would advise, if you want to take this for motivation to kind of get you started, that's great, but make sure you work on healthy eating habits, exercising while you're taking this. And when you stop taking this drug, because obviously you're not going to be taking it for the rest of your life, right? You have some habits to fall back on and you're not going to gain the weight and lose all of the motivation and kind of create this bad cycle with this drug for yourself, correct? So at the end of the day, I advise for you guys to stay safe, read into it, research more if you can, watch more videos, talk to your doctor, and maybe talk to them to give you a plan of taking it between for 20 to 60 weeks and see how it works and go from there. Make sure you keep an eye on the side effects that we mentioned on this video. If you experience any of them, talk to a professional, maybe stop taking the drug and, you know, go from there. That's it for this video. I hope this was helpful. If it was, please make sure you let me know in the comments. Like and subscribe as always. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.